Hello guys, welcome to Android tutorial. Today we shall learn Android application to demonstrate web services. Android application to demonstrate web services. So what is the meaning of web services? N number of clients used to send the data over the network to connect with different platforms. So take an example. Let me take the example for makemytrip.com. So what makemytrip.com used to do? Makemytrip.com provides the Android apps to the clients to engage their clients or customers, to book their hotels as well as to book their holiday trips or journeys from source to destination location. So in this case, the journeys may be bus, the journey may be air, the journey may be bus, or journey may be trains, railways, or some private taxis also. So how do they connect with different service providers parallelly, simultaneously? So in this case, they access the APIs. MakeMyTrip.com enterprise business application access the APIs of AirIndia.com or MakeMyTrip.com or MakeMyTrip business organization access the APIs of IRCTC to book the railway tickets. Or there might be a chance that MakeMyTrip.com uses MSRTC web portal APIs to reserve the seats for the customers. Means different platforms are trying to connect with the same applications. So this is the concept of web services. If I draw a pictorial diagram, in the pictorial diagram you might see the connection that I'm trying to perform from my MakeMyTrip.com to various organizations. So if I do have, let me show you somewhere. So take example classes. So here Java Technologies somewhere. Java Technologies, JDBC. I already have drawn the diagram somewhere. Let me check it. Let me show you. Web services. No. Where am I now? Day one. Okay, you can see this diagram, guys. You can refer this diagram. So this is tier one. So tier one, what is this tier one? This is the customer, this is the user. In tier two, assume this is the flipkart.com. So user enters the username and passwords and hit the enter button. Hit the enter and perform some shoppings and add the items to his cart or her cart. So in tier two, when the customer put for next request, that is payment options, then request will go to PayPal. So based on the user entered details, the PayPal will decide the card, the credit card or debit card belongs to which bank, the PayPal will decide the credit card belongs to Master Service Provider, Gateway Organization, or maybe Amex, or maybe Maestro, or maybe Rupee. Okay, so based on these gateways, the gateways will decide I am providing service to which bank. Maybe I am providing service to SBI. Or maybe I'm providing service to State Bank of Hyderabad. Maybe the card is MasterCard and providing services to the HDFC or ICICI. So these applications are connecting with each others by using web services, and they use as internally APIs. Okay, web services APIs to interact with each other. So you can use the same application for MakeMyTrip.com or any other services. So they can able to connect with each other by using these web services APIs. Okay, means user enters the details and simply perform the transaction and adding the items to his cars, and item will be delivered and payment will be deducted. But in this whole process, you can find here PayPal is one tier, gateway organization is one tier, banks are different tiers, Flipkart is one more tier, and user is one tier. So how these five tiers are connected with each others, how they are able to perform the operations. So this is one of the good example. To understand web services, or you can call enterprise application, So same way, let me implement in my application also. Okay, fine. So in my application, I'm going to work with the web services. To work with web services, I need web application. So this web applications accept the data from the client. So here my client is a Android application. Okay, fine. I need the server. So server, what is the purpose of server? to deploy the web application. Next, I need the database. I'm going to use the database to store or retrieve the data to and from the client. Next, I need the client application. Absolutely, client is my Android application. Next, I need the network. So in my case, I will use the hotspot of my current system, and that hotspot will be linked with the Android application, multiple Android clients, and my data will be sent to my server. And next is client app and the web application. Okay, boss. So here is web application. I'm going to create a web application in Java. That is here I will use servlets or JSP. Even you can use PHP also. Even you can use ASP also, or any other stuff. Okay, guys. Fine. Now you can use struts, or you can use Spring. Okay. Fine, guys. Next, server you can use. What is the first server you will feel comfort? You can use. I'm planning to use here Apache Tomcat. Okay. Next, you can use IIS also. You can use Glassfish, or you can use WebLogic, or you can use WebSphere. Okay, and etc. Okay, boss. So database, in my case, I'm using MySQL. You can use Oracle also. You can use Sybase also. Or you can use SQL Server also. Okay, you can use whatever the field you can feel comfort, you can use, guys. Okay, Android. See, absolutely, this is my Android app. Okay, network. I'll create the network later on. Okay, fine. Okay, but in my case, I'm going to use here servlets and JSPs. I'm going to use Apache Tomcat. I will use MySQL database, Android app, and network. Okay, guys, first of all, let me create the database in my application. That is, so how do I create the application? So here I'm using the MySQL database. So to connect with the MySQL database, I'm using SQL Yoke as a GUI, okay, fine. So already I installed MySQL in my, So let me launch my SQL Yoke. So this is my SQL Yoke. Hit the continue button, test connection. Okay. My username is root, password is root, port number is 3306, and it is in my current system, so localhost. Okay, fine. So you, here you can find a demo DB. Like this, let me create one more database. So here, right click on the root. So create database. Let me use MyDB. What is the database name? MyDB. So this is my MyDB. Okay, fine. So what is in MyDB? Let me check it. Okay, person and student, all the stuff. Otherwise, okay, fine. So background, all the query will be fired. So here you can see here, create database MyDB. To the MySQL. Fine, let me create the table. Next step. So here we have created my the database called MyDB. Okay, fine. Next, let me create the table. Step two, create the table in database. So here is MyDB is the database name, and I'm planning to create the table name called student info. So here, student info. Fine. So what are the names? Create table student info, SID varchar 10, sname varchar 30, int age, mobile, and email and password. So these are the attributes I'm planning to keep here. What is the table name? Here is student info. So SID, sname, age. So right click on MyDB, create table. So here is SID, int. Suppose you enter 10. Is it int or varchar I took? Let me check. So it's a varchar. Varchar of 10. Next, yes name. Varchar of 30 I entered. Next, what is next? Age, int. So I took 5. So what are the columns, remaining columns? Let me check it here. SID, sname, age. Next, mobile, email, password. Mobile, email and password. So here is mobile, mobile, varchar, not varchar, let me use int, and here is 10, and email, varchar of suppose 30, and here is password, I use a pass. Next is, here is varchar, and here is 30, okay, and hit the create table, hit the button called create table. So here give the name called student info, student info, hit OK. So once you hit the OK, you will get the dialog box, table created successfully, hit OK. It will ask you to create one more table. So I don't want to create one more table, simply hit no. Okay, fine. So in the background, you can see here create table. You can see here create table student info, SID varchar 10, sname varchar 30. Okay. Age, mobile, email, password. Okay, fine. The same query you will see here. Let me keep and paste. So, okay, fine. So, create table, MyDB, student info, and age and blah, blah, blah. So, these are the attribute column attributes. Okay, was fine. And when you show the data, view data, when you right click, view data. So, this is no data. And simply select star from MyDB, you can see here. Okay, fine. Table data. So next step, let's proceed. After creating this table, create table student info. After creating this table, let's proceed for creating the web application. Creating the web application. Before creating the web application, keep your Tomcat ready. Keep your Tomcat ready. That is Apache Tomcat. In my case, I'm using Apache Tomcat. Okay, keep your Tomcat, which is installed on your current system, ready on your system or computer, ready. Okay, fine. As well as database also. Let me create the web application. So whose name is student ERP, whose name is student ERP. Okay boss, fine. So already I created, let me remove that student ERP, or let me have the backup of the student ERP. So go to program files, let me have the backups first of all. So here is student ERP, go to web apps. So I created somewhere student ERP, let me copy somewhere. Classes, Android workspace, and here somewhere web services example. Okay, here let me paste. Okay, fine. Let me delete my existing application. I took the backup of this existing application, and let me delete this. Okay, fine. So here deleted, right click, delete. Yes, okay, deleted now. So first of all, just create the context root in the web app folder, web app. So context root. What is the context root? So this is the context root name, whose name is student ERP, web app folder of Tomcat, Apache Tomcat. Okay, fine. So let me give the path name where I installed my Apache Tomcat. So this is the web apps. So copy and paste here. So here you have to create, okay, web apps, not web app, web apps. Okay, fine. So student ERP, so copy, I don't need space, so here let me copy the name. So copy Windows E, go to same folder. So already folder is in open mode, so right click here, new folder, let me paste here, right click, paste. So this is your student ERP. Okay, and student ERP contains nothing, it's empty blank. Student ERP contains two pages, register JSP, login JSP, web INF directory, then web.xml file, classes, and MySQL connector bin.jar. Okay, fine. So let me create these pages. First of all, let me create the directory webinf, classes, and lib. So go to student ERP, right click, new folder, whose name is web-inf. Under webinf, you have to create two more folders whose names are classes, and one more folder whose name is lib. Okay, fine. So classes and lib, I created now. Done. Let me proceed for now, register.jsp. Okay, boss, fine. As well as let me add the bin.jar. So where is my, just now I copied and pasted here. So go to Android workspace 74 web services example, and here login register lib. Okay, so you can gather this jar. So MySQL connector, copy. So let me close and go to my lib. So here I pasted, pasted boss, fine. So I added jar also. Next, let's create the JSP. So copy this file name. So go to file menu, new, others. So here is my JSP. Hit okay. Okay, and first of all, save this application, save this file. Save. Where will you save? So let me go to my C drive, program files, Apache Software Foundation, Tomcat 9.0, web apps, and search for student ERP. Okay, here, and beside to webinf, you have to save register.jsp. Okay, hit save. Fine, boss. So under this JSP, you will find page import. That is java.sql.star. Okay, fine. And you have to get this string and all the stuff first. Okay, boss. Result set, prepare statement, and get the parameter. Okay, fine. So go to register.jsp and import the page. So left angle bracket, %@page, import java.sql.star. For importing, let me close the scriptlet tag here. So here I close the scriptlet tag, and let me create the parameter called. First of all, I need a result set and a prepared statement. So import the result set and prepared statement. So result set RS, so assign with null. So I need prepared statement also. Prepared statement PS. So initialize with the null. Next, after result set, I need connection. Connection con assigned with null. Okay, fine. Let me work with now after result set. Let me connect with the. Let me get the parameter. So string SID request dot get parameter. REQUEST request dot get parameter. So here is SID. What are the column names? SID. Let me check it here once again. So these are the column names. So SID, SName. Let me have the column names. So I'll hold these attribute name at same. Okay, fine. So let me remove this stuff. Varchar 10. I don't need. Okay, fine. So another two, where are another two? Okay, email and pass. Another two. Okay, here. Email. Okay, I don't need all this stuff. Fine. Fine, guys. So let me keep here string. String assigned with the request dot get parameter. Okay, semicolon, fine. So I need S name here. I don't need this single code also. So copy, control C. So let me copy this multiple times. 3, 4, 5, 6. So I need first this S name. So S name I kept here, and here is S name. I need age. So age is here. Next age is also here. Let me have the mobile number. So this is my mobile number. Okay, and here is also mobile number. Then next I need email. So put the email here, and here is also email. I need password. I need the password. So here is password. So I received all the attributes now. So escape, shift home, delete. Okay, boss, fine. So done, almost done. Okay, fine. Now we need to load the driver class. So first let me work with the try catch block. Try. Okay, fine. Under this try, let me use the catch block. So under the catch, let me handle the exception. Exception exception E. And here let me load the connection con. So first of all, let me load the driver class name, class dot for name. So what is the driver class name? Check it here. So we have received these attributes, that is result set, prepare statement, connection. Now driver class name, com.mysql.jdbc.driver. So I need this driver class name. So take this driver class name, com.mysql.jdbc.driver. So keep in double quote. Okay, fine. After this we need connection reference. What is the connection reference? I took here con. Con, assign with the con, assignment operator. So here is a driver manager dot, driver manager dot get connection. So here I have to pass three parameters. First is URL, second is username, and third is password. So JDBC colon MySQL colon. So you can find this, you can find these parameters here. So let me have the these parameters. Driver manager dot get connection. So let me pass to here. Tested. Okay. Driver manager dot get connection. JDBC colon MySQL colon slash slash. My database is in my current system. So I passed here localhost. The port number is 3306. And what is the database name I passed here? It is MyDB. Damn. What this pop-ups are coming. Okay, let me scroll up. Better. Let them come. So here is MyDB. Let me show you MyDB. Where is my MyDB? So this is my MyDB. This is the MyDB student info. Okay, fine. MyDB username is root and password is root. Okay, boss. Once you receive the connections, so we need to fire the query. We need to fire the query. So what is the query? Prepare statement ST. So here you need to insert the query, insert into your table name and the values. So con dot prepare statement. PS, in my case I took the variable name. Let me check what is the variable name I took here. Prepare statement PS, right? Prepare statement PS. So here is my PS. PS assign with the connection dot con dot prepare statement, and here to fire the query. So first of all, let me create the query here, con dot prepare statement. So this is the query. So let me hold the query into query variable, string query, because it will increase the width and the code may not be visible to you. So here is string query, and this is the query. So double quote is missing here. Okay, fine. So insert into student info, SID, S name, age, mobile, email, and password. Values, how many question mark? Must be 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And here, let me pass here my QRY query. Okay, boss, fine. Your query is done now. You have to execute and update this query. Now prepare statement con dot prepare statement. query you have passed. Next is you have to execute the query. So before executing the query, you have to set the parameter to your prepared statement. You have to set the parameter to your prepared statement. So let me set those parameters. And some parameters are integers, some parameters are strings. So here, let me get the parameter ps.setString. So 1, comma. What are the parameters are here? SID. SID is the first parameter. Next, ps.setString of 2, comma. Sname. ps.setString. What is third? Third is age. So here it should not be int. It should not be string. It's an int. Set int. Set int. And this is the third parameter. I have to typecast integer dot. Integer dot parse int. Okay. And here let me set the string. What is the string name? So here it must be age. So here is age. Okay. One more parenthesis. Next, let me pass for mobile ps dot set int of 4 and here integer dot parse int. काय करायचं
जर काय झालं मी तुमचं ऐकत नाही सर्वटिक बळदा सर्वटिकची जर मारून
माझं काय नाही
त्याच्यात नाव पाहिजे जर
इथं काहीच नाही माझ्या सर्टिफिकेट ठीक आहे. Next int, let me pass here mobile. Here is mobile and with semicolon. Next ps dot, let me set the string. Set string. Let me set the string. And this is fifth parameter. So here let me set for email. Email. Next ps dot set string. So here is sing 6. Here is password. Here is password. SID, sname, age, mobile, email, and password. Okay, boss, fine. Let's execute now. So int result assignment operator ps dot execute update. Execute update. Okay, fine. Now once you perform the execute update, int result res. Okay, fine. And let's proceed for checking the results now. So this is the if else block. Let me simply copy and paste. So if result, so in shop, okay, execute update here, remove, process the result. So how do we process? If your result is 0, means record is not inserted. If record is not inserted, so here out.println record not inserted. Record not inserted. Fine. If it is inserted, record inserted. So this message will display on a server console. Server console and a response to Android app. Response to Android app. Okay, fine. As well as our browser. Okay, fine. Our browser window. Okay, boss. Fine. Same here also. The system.out.println response to server console, and this is the response to Android app. Okay, boss. Fine. Next step is close the connections. Otherwise, you need to show the exception if any exceptions are persist. So simply put the exceptions in a print stack trace and close the connections and statements. Okay, fine. So here e dot print stack trace. Print stack trace, fine. And finally, let me get these variables and let me close. Copy and paste. First result set, then prepared statement, and then connection. Home, close. So here is close. Okay, fine. Delete. Dot close. Close. Okay, boss. Everything is closed now. Done. So this is yours. This is your register.jsp. This is the register.jsp. Just have a look. What are the things we have done? we have imported java.sql package, then result set we have initialized with null, prepared statement we have initialized with the null, and connection also we have initialized with the null. So get all the query strings parameters, SID, SNAME, age, mobile, email and passwords. Next, load the driver class name, that is com.mysql.jdbc.driver, and get the connection by passing to driver manager.getConnection jdbc:\localhost:3306, and this is my database name, and username to my database is root and password is root, and the query to be fired to the database, that is insert into student info, and the column names like SID, SNAME, age, mobile, email, password, and the values. This is a prepared statement where you use the question marks and six parameters are here, and ps dot prepare statement, that is the query, this is the query where I pass, and set the parameter to the prepared statement, that is set string SID, set string student name, set int integer dot parse int of age, because it's a integer values, number values, ps dot set int for integer dot parse int of mobile, ps dot set string 5 email, and last is password, and finally execute the query by using execute update method. Definitely you will get the response in integer values 0 record updated or 1 record updated. If it's 0 record not inserted, that is RNI, and apart from 0, if record is inserted, I am sending the response state, that is record inserted, to the Android app as well as browser. So anyhow, it's a web services app. I need not show any message to the server console, but for my confirmation, I am sending the message to my server console, as well as let me send the response to my Android app, that is record inserted. So based on the response I received to my Android app, I will show the next activity or next page in my Android, that is welcome message, or I will ask to the user to perform the login once registration done, because I am processing username and password as the email ID as username and password is as it is. So after entering the username and password, so user can enter this username and password, email and password into my login page or login activity. Once user enters that login activity user details, I will prompt to the welcome page where the user can perform their own operations. Okay, fine. So this is the register page done. So simply save. So here. Next, we'll proceed for now. Android application now. Now this is my web application is done. Web application I done for register now. Parallel, let me work with creating the Android app. So login is also there. Login.jsp. This will proceed later on. First, let me show you record insertion. So go to step 4. Create the Android project in Android Studio. So parallelly, I need to start my Android Studio also. So let me start my Android Studio here. So battery down. Okay. So here is my Android Studio. Okay. Fine. So Android Studio is starting. We have to wait until it has to start. I think it will take time to start. Let me apply some more coolants and all the stuff here. Okay, you can see here Android Studio is starting. So wait for a minute, let Android Studio to start. Come on, it is taking too much time to start my Android Studio. Okay guys, so already I created this application, that is web services example. So let me create the same example here. So start a न्यू अँड्रॉइड प्रोजेक्ट, क्लिक ऑन स्टार्ट अ न्यू अँड्रॉइड स्टुडिओ प्रोजेक्ट. And let me give the name called same web services example 2. Okay, web services example 2. Hit the next. Select minimum SDK. Hit the next. Select empty activity. Hit the next. And finally hit the finish. So it will start the project. It will create the Android Studio will create the project whose name is 75 web services example 2. Okay, fine. So let me proceed for Android. Notes till then. Project has to create. First of all, we need to add the internet permissions to your Android application. So add the internet permission in a manifest file. So how will you add? Simply open the manifest file. Once you open the manifest file, you have to type left angle bracket user's permission android colon name android dot permission dot internet, because your Android app is looking for internet permission to send the data over the network, because my server app is in my server app system and Android app is in my Android device. So how can I connect them? So I need a common network between them. To connect my Android application to the web application. So for that purpose, I need to add the internet permission. I have to add internet permission. So accept here. What the issue with Android Studio? Let me check it. Okay, it's starting. Just wait a minute. Still Gradle build running. Close. Okay, good. Refreshing VCS history, updating indices. Okay, good. Almost done. Good guys, my application is ready now. So this is the layout, activity underscore main. So instead of main activity, let me change the name of main activity to register activity. Okay. Let me change. Still indexing and refresh. Okay, fine. Tab to refresh, still indexing. Maps application zala? Map zala ka? At least SMS? Wi-Fi? Okay. Accelerometer? Compass. Okay, fine. So let me refactor. I'm planning to give the name as a. First of all, let me add the permission. So how do I add? So add the permission to your manifest file. User's permission. So copy. So here I copied. Internet permissions, go to manifest file, Android manifest, open the manifest file. So you can add somewhere, scroll down. So users permission android dot permission dot let me add for internet. So here I added for internet. Done. So once you add the permission, let me change the name. Once you add the permissions, so next step, add the Wally related APIs to Android applications. So add the Wally APIs to your Android applications. How will you add? Go to build.gradle. Go to build.gradle. So where is your build.gradle? So expand the Gradle scripts. So here you will find. Here you will find build.gradle. Open build.gradle and scroll down. Scroll down. So add somewhere here. Add somewhere here. Okay, fine. But do confirm your system is connected to the internet. So let me connect here. Okay, sign in Google. Let me check internet is connected or not. Yeah, it's connected now. Fine, let me add the Wally APIs related Gradles to my application. So where is my Gradle? So here you can see compile com.android.wally:. Okay, so copy this, copy the name and go to Gradle. So simply paste it here. Okay, fine. So this is the Gradle. Fine. So you need to hit on sync now, but do confirm your system is connected to the internet. Confirm system is connected to the internet. Okay, now it is building the Gradle. So till then we'll go for next step. Fine. So check your system or computer is connected to the internet and then sync project and then sync the project. So you can sync from here also. I have to sync now, or you can sync, you can click on here sync, synchronize. Okay, either this button or you can click here also, the button which appears here, sync now. Okay, done guys, my Gradle successfully built. Now I don't need Gradle, I don't need manifest. Next, let me proceed for designing the activity. So I'm looking for register. I'm looking for the name whose name is register. So I don't need main activity. So let me give the names properly. So instead of main activity, let me rename. So how do you rename? Right click on main activity. Right click on main activity. Search for refactor. Search for refactor. You will find rename. You will find here rename. Rename. So give the name called register. Okay, register. So register activity. Okay, register activity. Refactor. Refactor. So it will change the name, as well as it will change the name in manifest file also. You can find your register activity. It's a launcher activity. And let me change the name to my layout. So here also I'm planning to change the name here too. So right click on activity underscore main. So here right click, refactor, rename. So instead of main, let me give the name as a register, refactor. Okay, fine, refactor. So then find register, activity underscore register, and here is register activity. Okay boss, fine. So here I don't need relative layouts. I am looking for linear layout. Okay, fine. So this is my linear layout. Let me align my elements by using orientation. Let me keep it vertical. Let me keep it vertical. So this is the vertical, as well as let me keep scroll view here. Let me apply scroll view. So if the contents may not be visible properly, so control X, let me scroll down, control V. Okay, fine. Scroll view is closed now. Let me add layout width and height. So here is match parent, and let me add the width also. So here let me add layout width, let me go for match parent. Okay, fine. So done. So scroll view. Okay guys, so I don't want to spend much more time on designing these activities. So simply I will perform the copy and paste XML code, because to create this layout it consumes much more time. So I need text view. I need this text view, student registration. Student registration. Okay, fine. So simply this text view. Okay, fine. So go to design. So this is the student registration. Okay, fine. I need one more text view to show college name. So instead of student registration, let me give here CSMSS CSCOE Aurangabad. Okay. AURANGABAD. Fine. Let me keep everything in the center. So let me apply the gravity here. So center. Let me keep in top. So check it how it looks. No, it is not coming properly. Let me change the font instead of 35 to 35, because I want to show all the contents to be on same location. And padding top is 15 dp. Let me remove the padding top. Okay, fine. And 25 to 26. And this color I'm looking for. I'm spending much more time on designing, so I want to skip this tag. How can I go to design? Okay, fine. So here MH India. Okay boss, fine. So 2533. Okay, fine. MH India DT 2533. So scroll down and padding top. Let me remove this padding top. Fine. So design. Go to design. This is your student registration. This is the student registration. Done. Okay, boss. Now let me work with now. Let me add some other fields like student ID, student name, student age, student gender. Not gender. I'm not taking here gender. Mobile number, email ID, and password. Okay, fine. So here I do have edit text. So edit text. You can perform by using drag and drop also. So this is the button. Okay, so copy this time, copy this XML code. Because it takes much more time, so I skip this content to typing. So this is for student registration. So this is the edit text. This edit text contains layout width, match parent, layout height, wrap content. Enter the student ID. Input type is text. Input type is text. Text size is 25 dp. Whose ID is SID, and padding is 10 dp. So just have the look how it appears now. Student ID, student name. Okay. Student age, mobile number, email ID, and password. Okay. So this is the look. This is the look, guys. Okay, fine. So this is about student ID. Same for student name. Just what will change? The text will change. That is hint, enter student name, and ID is S name. Okay, fine. Next, just and I'm looking for age. Hint is enter age. Input type is number, because I want to enable the number keyboard, number keypad, and whose ID is age. Whose ID is age. Next, I'm looking for one more edit text. Whose hint is enter mobile number, whose ID is mobile, and here padding is 10. Next edit text for email. Next edit text for enter email. Next is whose input type is text email address. Whose input type is text email address. You can check it here. How can I check? So you will see a text email address, text email subject. Okay, fine. Text size is 25 dp and okay boss, fine. This is the ID for this email ID is email. One more edit text for password. One more edit text for password. So here I'm asking for hint to the user. Enter password whose input type is text password and ID is password. So okay guys, so I'm not using on click. So let me remove on click. So here is a listener. I am applying on, I am working on the listener. Even you can work on OnClick also. Even you can work on OnClick also, not to worry. Okay, fine. So button, layout width, wrap content. So layout height is wrap content. Input type, so instead of submit, save student to server. Server database. Okay. एक वस्ता एक वस्ता लैब चला ओके सेव स्टूडेंट सर्वर डेटाबेस ओके बॉस फाइन ओके डन सो सेव स्टूडेंट टू सर्वर डेटाबेस सो दिस इज रजिस्टर बटन सो लेआउट ग्रेविटी हॉरिजॉन्टल फाइन सेंटर हॉरिजॉन्टल सो दिस इज द पेज Done, guys. Now let's proceed for now. Next step, we will proceed for next step now. Register activity. Register activity. So these are the import statement. That is operating system handler, app compact activity, bundle, log, view, button, widget, authentication failure, retry policy, network error. So these are for Wally API. No connection error, parse error, request queue, response, server error. Timeout, Wally error, toolbox, string request and toolbox Wally, hash map and map. Okay, so let me copy those imports. Actually directly also you can import by using alt enter, but you have to hit enter, alt enter multiple times to skip this part. So I copied and pasted OS handler, app compact activity and bundle view. Okay, authentication failure. So these import package which are belongs to these import package which are belongs to Wally API. This is for util package and this is your register activity. Okay, fine. Okay boss, done. Next step, let us find those widgets or views. So here I'll find buttons and request queue and string request and request queues. Okay, fine guys. So first of all, let me find those edit text. So what are the edit text? SID, S name, then age, then mobile. Let me check the column names or not here. I'm clicking here. So go to register and there you'll find those attributes. SID, S name, age, mobile, email and password. Okay, fine. So where is my studio? Here. SID, S name, age, mobile. Next is email and next is password. Okay. And I'm looking for button whose name is REG. I need string request. So string request, I need request queue. So request queue. So request queue. Okay guys, fine. Let us find out those widgets. So here is string request and request queue. I need the URL. We need to connect that URL. So for time being, let me copy this URL here. We'll change the URL later on because IP may change here. So you have to keep the IP address. Okay. So here is the IP address I want to configure. Okay, fine. Here is the IP address. Otherwise, I will ask the user, please enter the IP address also. We'll get that IP address and we'll keep here. Okay, fine. We'll get that IP address and we'll ask the user to keep here. Okay, boss, fine. So here is the IP address. Otherwise, can we have one more field? whose name is IP address. Control C, Control V. So I will ask to the user after password, enter IP address. Enter IP address. So here is a input type is text. So here I will take IP. Okay, fine. So let's see how the looks appears. Okay, fine. So let me change the font to instead of 1010 dp padding 1010, let me keep it a 55 padding because space is increasing too much. So here let me keep here 55 dp because I want to show all 55 dp. Okay, now see how it looks. Okay, now enter IP address, enter password, enter email, enter mobile number, and enter the IP address. Enter the server IP address. Enter server IP address. Okay, fine. Okay, boss, fine. So you can see the design. So I'm planning to set the server also. Okay, boss. So done. So let me have one more edit text whose name is IP. Okay, fine. So after receiving this one, so here IP address, I need to hold this IP address later on. Next, let's proceed for now. Let's find those widgets now. First of all, so where are the widgets? Widgets are here. Actually IP address, okay, no matter, wherever you want to keep, you can keep at the top or here also. Okay, fine, because anyhow we are performing the operation within the onClick, within the onClick only. Okay, insert user. So for time being, let me keep it here. Okay, fine. So here, just find out those widgets. So SID, assignment operator, typecast into edit text, find view by ID, r dot ID dot SID. So copy 3, 4, 5, 6. So here I'm not looking for SID. So SName. Here I'm not looking for. I'm looking for age. So age is gone. Next, let me enter mobile. So here next I'm looking for password. Password. And here what do you need? IP. IP. Okay. Fine. So here is IP. Okay, here I'm looking for password. Okay, something is missing. Okay, email is left now. Email is left. So here is email, and here must be email. Okay, so here is mobile. Here is age. So here is S name. Okay, fine. All my 7 widgets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, boss. I got it now. I got all these widgets. Okay, done. So next step, let's proceed for next step. After working, we need to apply the listener. We have to apply the listener now. So I need the listener. I need the listener first. So what is my button name? So just find a button name also. REG assignment operator typecast into button. So find the button, find view by ID R dot ID dot REG register. So this is the REG dot set on click listener, new listener. Okay, fine. So get the values. Get the values string. What are the values like SID? So get code into SID 1. So SID dot get text dot to string. Okay, let me perform the trim operation. Okay, so fine. I need this for multiple times. So here in shop SID, let me copy and paste for here for other parameters. So Control C, Control V, Control V. For how many times now? 4 times. 5, 6, 7. Okay, fine. So let me append only this parameter. So here S name. So here also I am looking for S name. S name 1. S name 1. Okay, so here I think next is age 1. So age. Okay, after age, what is next? Mobile. Next is mobile 1. Mobile 1. After mobile, next is email. Here is email 1. Email 1. So here is next password 1. Okay, so here is password 1. Okay boss, fine. I think this I can get it here directly. Before clicking only directly I can get it, because so here Control X. So here I do have IP. So IP. Okay, fine. So string IP. Okay, on create IP will not work here, because so IP string. So this is the IP string. So directly when on create you will get the IP as a string as a null, na? So when a button gets clicked, at that time only I am looking for this. So no, this logic won't work. So let me keep here. So here, okay, fine. So it should not be pass 1, it should be pass. So first of all, let me show you those parameters. So here, let me keep all the parameters in toast dot make text. So what is the current context? So register activity dot this. So here, let me show you all the parameters. So SID. So what is the name? SID 1. Okay, fine. So just let me append. Okay, fine. So here is S name. Okay, no need of listener, no need of toast. So delete. Fine, just let me try run. You can try and run on your own device as well as in system also, but my intention is to run on my own device. So here Gradle build running successfully. Next we need to apply on the delay event. Okay, so I need event here. Okay, fine. So let me use new handler dot post delayed. Okay, fine. So new handler, and let me get that event, that is a new handler dot post delayed dot, so post delayed. So it work on listener, that is whose name is new runnable, and second parameter is, so let me call runnable, and after runnable, so here I am looking for some seconds of delay. Okay, that is milliseconds of delay. Okay, boss. So here is semicolon. Fine. And here I have to perform the logic. Here to perform the logic of inserting the user. Inserting the user. So simply call the method. Call the method to insert or to send the user data to server database. To server database. Okay, boss. Fine. So let me write one method whose name is insert user. Okay. So here is my insert user method. I need to create this method, don't worry. Insert user. Okay, fine. So insert user and blah 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 blah. So that we need to create one method whose name is insert user. So close it here. This is end of on create. End of on create method. Okay guys, so you have to create the method whose name is insert user. So copy, so public void, void, otherwise let me use boolean, void directly, void insert user opening closing curly. Okay, fine. So here I need strings, final string. So let me copy for multiple times. Control C, Control V, Control V, Control V, Control V, Control V. So if it is not visible, let me hit enter. Okay, fine boss. So done. Okay boss, fine. What the issue? If it is not accessed, let's make them final. So here is final. Okay, so I have to copy for multiple times. So here copy paste, or I made all the string as a final. Okay, done. Okay boss, so here let me make here string as a final string IP. Okay, with initially empty, and here let me append the string URL here. I'll change that IP. Okay, string IP, fine, IP1. Done boss. So next, let's write the logic for to insert the data. Insert the data. So actually I'm looking for this IP. So here when you click on IP, so string IP assign with IP1. Okay, so this IP will be received and it will be assigned to this IP. It will be assigned to this IP, guys. Okay, fine. That is string IP. Okay. So simply let me call here toast message. Otherwise, let me write the logic now to perform the operation. So here I need string request. I need string request with the new string request, and I need post URL. Response listener. Okay, fine. So here go to insert user. So here I need string request assign with new string request. So I need the method called guest. What type of method you want to send to the server? Get based or post based? So you can use request dot method dot get. So here is request dot method. So what is the method name you want to send? Post method, delete method, get or post, or get or head. I want to send the post base. Next, you have to pass the URL. So what is the URL? Let me check it. URL here. So what is the URL here? So here you took the URL. Here we took the URL. Okay, fine. So let me append the URL with the. Let me append the URL with my string IP. Okay, fine. Otherwise, let me create the URL here only. So Control X. And let me access the URL here. Better. Okay, fine. So let me create the URL here, URL 1, and up to here only. Okay, fine. Otherwise, let me pass one more parameter, that is IP address. So here is IP. Okay, IP 1, and let me create one more parameter, comma string IP 1, and here let me call it the final. Okay, final IP 1. So based on this IP, I can able to send the data. Okay, now let me get that IP. So I need this IP now. I don't need this IP here. Control X or Control Z. So string IP, string IP. What is IP address here? Assign with the IP one. Okay, guys. Now this is IP 1. Next, URL path. So here I need final. I don't need this final string here. So here one more string. String IP. So context path. Context URL path. Assign with the. Let me assign with here. So I don't need here. Okay, boss. Fine. Otherwise, IP and port number. Okay, fine. So enter the IP address, comma port number. So let me here IP address. IP address, comma colon port number. So let me check the design, how it appears now. Okay. So instead of 25 dp, 23 dp. Okay, fine. Colon port number, done. So here is port number. Okay, fine. So here I need to concatenate that URL. So how can I concatenate? So here one more string final URL. Final URL assigned with the URL 1 plus string IP plus string IP plus context path. So I can pass here final URL. Final URL. Okay, fine. So after final URL, next we'll proceed for next parameter. So here is semicolon. So some other parameter. Some other parameter. Okay, fine. So you can see here it takes first method, next URL. We have to apply the listener. We have to apply the listener, then error listeners. Okay, and finally string request. So these are the parameters, 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5 parameters. So string request takes 5 parameters. So takes 5 parameters. 5 parameters. So let me have those 5 parameters here. Control C. Control V. Okay, may not be visible to you. What are the parameters? Let me show you here. Okay. So these are the parameters. Okay, boss, fine. Now that we pass next parameters, so by using listener now, what is next now? We have to apply the listener, that is new response listener. New response listener, and we need to override the on response method. So here, new response listener. Let me check it here. What are the listener name? So here on response. So here is on response. Fine, boss. So this is for up to here. String request, and this is for, let me show you full method because this may create the confusion in between you. So I need next parameter here, okay? And after this response, I need error response, error listener. Next parameter is error, new error listener, new error listener. So next is new error listener. So after error listener, after error listener, next term, once error listener gets completed, let me check it here, where the error listener ends here. So this is your error listener. Let me check it, error listener. And here after error listener, we need authentication failure. We need authentication failure, that is map format. And when we need string request set retry policies. Okay, fine. Next comma. So error listener, then error listener, done. This is error listener, and after error listener we need to add, okay guys, so on response, what we have to do once the response gets done. Okay, fine. So let me check where it ends now. Error listener, it ends here. Okay, fine. So this is the body of my method on constructor. On constructor, fine. So okay guys, done. We are almost done. Okay, it ends here. Fine guys, so this is the logic. So here also we need to write the logic here in the method only. So first of all, let me complete with on response first of all. So go to on response. If you go to on response, so here is on response. So in the on response, if response is done, then we'll send the response to, we'll send the request to next new activity. So here is my, I need to add here, control check. Home. So here, let me get all those errors. So if it is not visible to you, where is that? So here let me add the response. Here we need to add the response, if response committed. Okay, fine. Let me get that response and let me put it here. If response, then here is the response. Here is the response. So if response dot equals, so okay, fine. Because this response is coming from my server. This response coming from my server. So where is the response here? Let me check it. Volley error. Oh, don't paste in here, boss. You are committing mistake here. Here is the response. Here is the response. So you see response record inserted is coming from, record inserted is coming from where, boss? It is coming from my JSP page, register JSP page. You can check it here. Record inserted. Record inserted. Record inserted. Okay. So this I'm comparing with my, I'm comparing it here. Okay, fine. Control shift W. Okay, may not be visible. So record inserted successfully, and I'm planning to send to welcome page. Okay, fine. So send to welcome page. Record inserted successfully, and send the response to home page. Okay, fine. Okay, boss. So this is a toast message. Done. And when your error occurs, we have to show these messages, error messages. These number of errors like network error, connection failure error. Okay, fine. So let me have those errors. So right click, copy, simply timeout errors and blah blah blah, these errors. Even you can skip also, no matter. On error response. So go to on error response. So here, tested. Okay, fine. So if error, let me show you what is the error here. So same everywhere. So register activity. Right, this is belongs to network error. This is belongs to network error. Okay, fine. This is belongs to what, boss? So this is belongs to server error. Okay, and this is belongs to what, boss? Authentication failure error. Okay, fine. So this is belongs to parse error, if your query string is not passed successfully. And here is, this is connection timeout error, connection error if connection is aborted. Okay, fine. And this is belongs to timeout error, if your connection is timed out, if your connection is timed out. Okay, boss, fine, done. Now next, we'll proceed for after inserting the errors. Let's proceed for now the constructor body. Okay, constructor body, that is you're trying to put your all the information, you're trying to put all the information. So here in the parameters, so go to here and here control V, pasted. Okay, protected map. So this parameterized constructor, this is the parameterized constructor we are trying to put here. Actually your constructor ends here now. New request string, new request. Okay, first parameter, second parameter, third parameter. Okay, fine. So scroll down. So this is the third parameter. So map in the form of, so you are passing student ID, student name, age, mobile number, email and passwords. So there are six fields: student ID, student name, age, mobile number, email ID and passwords. And return all the parameters. Okay, boss, fine. And this is the URL, final URL. Okay, boss, fine. Final URL, then your IP address followed by, okay, let me remove this parameter also. Okay, fine. So here I removed. So it will look like, finally it will look, your URL will look like, how it will look like? http://192.168, like 192.168, the port number, IP address 123.1 something like 2020. Okay, this is the URL and IP. Okay, fine. Next term, after this it will look your student, student, student erp slash register.jsp. okay, so this final URL will look like this. Okay, boss, fine. Next, let's proceed for now. Next, guys, tomorrow lunch time, I will go. Has everyone done entries in the muster? Okay, I'll take the attendance from the same and you can leave. Those who want to leave. Next, after this, let me proceed for next step. Call the string request. Call the string request object and call the set retry policy. Set retry policy. Okay, boss. Fine. So here is call the string request string request object with a set retry policy. Okay, fine. So here is a string request, set retry policy, new default policy. For every 10 seconds it will retry. So it retry default default maximum retries multitasking, and finally you are calling request queue and add the string request, request queue and call the string request. So this is your application, this is the application, and finally I'm showing here. So once you student registered successfully, student data saved successfully to server database, server database. Okay boss, fine. So this is almost done. Let me proceed for next step and finally test the application, finally test the application. So here I'm testing, I have planned to test, so I'm testing this application, this application, application on my physical physical Android device. Google Maps झालं, Google Maps झालं का, SMS झालं, सेंड झालं का, नेक्स्ट वायफाय झालं. आय एम टेस्टिंग दिस ॲप्लिकेशन ऑन माय फिजिकल अँड्रॉइड डिवाइस ऑन माय रेडमी, बट नॉट इन एव्हीडी ऑर एम्युलेटर. ओके, आय विल शो यू, डोंट वरी. सो वेर इज माय डिवाइस, सो दिस इज माय डिवाइस. सो आय नीड केबल कनेक्शन्स, आय नीड डेटा केबल. सो लेट मी गेट द डेटा केबल हियर. सो हियर इज माय डेटा केबल. So data cable is here. Let me install this APK to my physical device. Okay, fine, done. So go to application and test it. So run the application. So this is my Xiaomi Redmi. Where is my screen recorder? So let me start my screen recorder and I will show the output to you. Do you use screen recorder? Okay, it's here. So let me start. It will take time to build the Gradle as well. I made mistake here. Actually, I need to start a server also. Till then let it build. So next step, before testing the application, so step, what other step is it? Start the Tomcat server, start the Tomcat server. Okay, so I'm going to so go to C drive slowly because it is taking time. First let it complete, first let it, let the build complete. Once build gets completed, then we'll proceed adding the Tomcat server and we'll reinstall the APK. So wait, so hurry is not good. So take it easy, running interfaces and everything. Let the Gradle to build. So here is my C drive, program files. Go to Apache Software Foundation. installing APK. You can see here installing APK. But let me start the server launching activity. Activity is launched in my application. So till then, let me go to Tomcat bin. You can see here. As you can see here, this is the activity. Okay. So this is the activity which is installed in my physical device. So till then, let me start a server, Tomcat 9. Run as administrator. Hit the yes, because first let me perform the setup. Start the Tomcat server. Start the Apache Tomcat server. Okay. Start the Apache Tomcat server. Fine. Then we need next step. I need virtual router. So here I need virtual Wi-Fi router. So to connect my Android device to server computer. So this is my the current operation I'm performing on my server computer, and Android is here. So I have my Wi-Fi router. Otherwise you can use a hotspot also. Hotspot. Okay, fine. So hotspot, where is my Wi-Fi? Let me search my Wi-Fi. So this is my Wi-Fi. So let us start my Wi-Fi. So my server is started now. And it is running on a port number called 2020. Let me check it here. What the error is? Error is belongs to, I don't care, lifetime and all the stuff, null pointer. So just I'm looking for my application. What is the server number? Can you find anywhere? 2020. So http://http-neo2020. Okay, so this is the server number. So here is mark. Let me show you server number. Edit, mark, and this is the server number. Okay, fine, boss, done. So let me start my Wi-Fi, sorry, hotspot, and till then let me start the recording also. So start, 3, 2, 1. So my application is launched now, but here is my application is launched. You can see here as application is launched here. Okay, parallelly you can see in the camera, as well as let me start my Wi-Fi here. Wi-Fi, let me go to Wi-Fi. Is it connected to my Wi-Fi or not? So here, yeah, it is connected to Redmi 4. Done. So you can see here, home. Fine. So home is connected to my laptop, sorry, my mobile device. Home is connected now. So where is my system? Laptop is getting hang, sorry, not laptop, mobile. So vibrate, make it off. Fine. So let me show you for next step. And here let me pause for time being. Where is that? So pause it here, and let me proceed for next step. Here is my next step. So start the hotspot and connect. Start the hotspot, or you can use Wi-Fi router also. Wi-Fi router. Connect your Android device to router or hotspot. Okay, hotspot. I connected now. So connect your Android device to your router or hotspot. So server and Android device will be in same network. Same network. Okay, fine. So next step. What is the step? Let me check it here. Step, I'm not able to remember exactly. Somewhat 5, 6, 7. Okay. Step next. Let me use the name called next. Step next. Next step. So here is next step. Step next. Okay. I'm not even remember. So server. So server and Android device will be in the same network. Okay, fine. So just check. So just check the IP address. IP address of Wi-Fi Ethernet. Wi-Fi Ethernet. Ethernet. Okay. So I'm going to command prompt. Go to command prompt. So here is command prompt. Use IP config. So you can see here Ethernet adapter. So I'm not looking for Ethernet adapter locally here. This is for LAN. This is for LAN. Let me remove the LAN connection. So I removed the LAN connection. Let me work with IP config. Okay, now IP config. I removed the LAN connection now. So you can see it, last time it was connected, but now it is not connected. So if I show you once again, you will get two. I removed the LAN connection now. So scroll up. So 192.168.23.1. This is for wireless LAN. Wireless LAN adapter, wireless network connection 2. Wireless LAN adapter. So let me copy simply. So right click, mark. So here, let me use this IP address. Not here, here. Okay, fine. So here is IP config. Okay, fine. So I need this IP. I need this IP. Okay, fine. Next step is test the application. Test the application and enter the IP and port number. And port number of server. So here is IP address, this one, and port number is 2020. Port number is 2020. You can check it here. So go to server console. So here is port number 2020. Okay, boss, fine. So let me show you parallelly the server also and MySQL also. Let me minimize somewhat. So here let me minimize. Oh no. Scroll left. So let me keep this server at left, server console at left side, and do observe parallelly on the server console. Okay. And first let me check with my current system. So go to browser. So localhost, localhost colon 2020. So student ARP slash register dot JSP. So it is saying that semicolon missing. Where is that semicolon missing? At line number 17. Go to 17 line number, register.jsp. 17 17 17. Yes, it's semicolon missing is here. Semicolon, and just hit the save. Save all. Then refresh one more time. Okay. To complete the local variable declaration. So insert semicolon. I inserted. Control F5. It is taking too much time. Why so? Let me go to server. Because my system may get stuck. So let me close all this unnecessary stuff. So 23 exit, exit exit, and let me close this also because I don't want to keep the burden on my laptop. Minimize. which is my mobile email, mobile IP address. So 2, so minimize, stop it, register.jsp. So just I do have one fear, this should not reach to 100%. If it reach, then it may create the problem. Okay, fine. So go to browser, browser console, still loading. Control C, let me start the browser once again. Control V, register.jsp. Why it is taking too much time? Localhost 2020 student ERP, register.jsp. Otherwise, let me stop the server and start once again. Better way. It's easy way. Okay, close. Fine. And where is my server console? Go to server, C drive, program files, Apache Software Foundation. Go to Tomcat 9. Go to bin and Tomcat 9. Yes. And close this window. Let it start. First of all, let me check it by going to server console 2020. Okay, server started now. So username is boss, password is boss. Where is my register? Control F. Student. Student ERP. Okay. So go to student ERP. Here is. And just register.jsp. Okay. Again, it's showing the error. That is. What is that? Error occurred line number 38. What is 38? RS. It's not RS. It's a PS. What is the prepared statement variable name? It's a PS. Here RS and here is PS. So scroll down, close the RS and PS. Close, then. Okay, I don't want page down. So remove RS, removed. Okay. And then retest, control F5. Okay, now go to server console. Is an error appear here? Definitely integer.parseInt java dot number format exception. Very good. Means request is going to server without any syntax. Okay, without any syntax errors. Now let me show you my both. Okay, fine. One side is server, one side is database. Now let me try in my Android app. Let me try in my Android app. So where is my Android app? Let me start it here. Let me go to my mobile device. So here is my mobile device, physical hardware device. Let me test and I'll show you. So here, let me start the recording again in my device. So connected now. What is the IP address? Check it once again. My IP address here, 192.168.23.1. So here student ID, let me enter the student ID. So I will enter all the details here. So what are the enter? So enter the student ID, that is Ganesha. So no, student ID is, suppose I took S1, student ID is S1, and you need to do parallel observe here. S1, enter student name is Ganesha, G-A-N-E-S-H-A, Ganesha. Enter age, suppose I enter 20. Enter mobile number 98543, some mobile number 985464. Email ID is Ganesha @gmail.com. gmail.com. Fine. Enter the password is GANESHA. So let me check it once again. GANESHA. Enter the server IP and port number in this way. So here is 192 192.168.23.1. So here 192.168.192.168.23.1 :2020. Okay, so I have filled the form 192.168.23.1:2020. So this is the form you can see here. Okay, fine. So here I will enter all the details. Now let me hit the save the student. Now observe, you may get error or you may get the you will get error or you will get the response. That's it. Fine. After this error, now let me check it now by entering the submit button. So hit the button now. Save student to server database. Either you should get error. So 75 web services example has stopped. Cancel. Why it is stopped? Let me check. Again, I have to enter all the details. Yes, one. Okay, let me check the crash reports in on my server console. Android monitor. Why it is stopped? Terminal. Just hold on. So let me make it pause till then. So here is pause. No such method exception. Message queue. Best match. Reflect. Okay. OpenGL. No such method. Okay, let me try once again. Yes, one. I have to enter every time, boss. That's GANESHA Ganesh. Suppose I enter 20 98564 something mobile number. GANESHA@gmail.com. Okay, and password is GANESHA. So 192.168.192.168. What is the pass? What 192.168.23.1:2020. So check it by going to server. Here is string. Page up. http://// your IP address, string IP, then student ERP, then register.jsp. Okay, fine. So Control C Control V. So here 192.168.23.1. okay, fine. Definitely I need to expect the error on the server console. So here, good. Is it last one? Yeah, new one. So I'm expecting this ERP. So first let me try by using this. So Control C and let me modify. Control C and let me paste to my server console. String context URL path. Control C. So here assign. So but here I had to keep here like this double quote. Okay, fine. It is not showing any error also, that's the issue. Control Z, not this one. Not context URL, final URL. String final URL. Control Z. So here is I'm looking for this URL and okay, fine. So this URL must be here. Insert, control C and paste. Okay, string final URL. Fine. Now let me deploy once again and hit OK. Now this time I won't enter the IP address. Attempt to invoke virtual method. Let me check what is the virtual method, which method is trying to invoke. So here is my app, S1, GANESHA, 20 9856 something number. So here is GANESHA. Ganesha@gmail.com. Password is GANESHA and here. Okay, fine. So let me view the summary. What the summary is? View summary. Attempt to invoke virtual method com.wall.request.wally request queue on the null object reference. What is the null object reference? Let me check null object. Line number 146. This is 146. View line numbers. Where I can see line numbers, boss? Edit. Where is line numbers? Show line number. Now let me go for 146. So line number is 146. So it is showing that null here. Let me check it null here. Request queue. So this is my request queue. And in the request queue, add string request. Add string request. So this is the string request. So what the issue here? Let me check default retry policy and all the stuff. Why it is showing the string request as a null? Let me check it here. String request. And I think string request to have passed the IP. Okay. String request, boss. I made mistake here. The mistake is go to app, scroll up. Where is my string request? We need to initialize. So this is the string request. And request queue must be this one. Okay. So I forget to request queue. So copy request queue to the Wally and then perform the operation. So definitely we'll get the error. So let me stop. I think it's running mode, na? Pause. Let me make it pause. So here I made a mistake here. So sorry, it's my mistake. Request queue. So initialize the request queue. I forget to initialize. Initialize the request queue. Okay, boss. Fine. Don't forget to initialize the request queue. Okay, boss. Fine. So this is important. Now let me rerun again. So go to server. Hit the enter, select your Android app and then install again. Now this time must and should without any error, because if any errors, then definitely the error will be, definitely that error might be. Okay guys, now see here. Now let me show you. Okay, I want to show you this database as well as server console parallelly. Where is that server console? Is here. I think again I need to scroll left, scroll down. Not this much of bigger space. Okay, this is more than enough. This is more than enough. So you can see the difference. So student ID is S1, student name is GANESHA Ganesha, student age is 20, enter mobile number 9856, some enter mobile number and email address is GANESHA@gmail.com. Enter password GANESHA. Server IP is not required now. Fine. this time error or record inserted. You can see a record inserted. Record inserted. This is the message. So record inserted. Edit mark. Just do observe. Record is inserted now. And go to database, refresh. So S1 Ganesha 209865 something and Ganesha. Now it will be performed by using IP address. Let me perform by using IP address. As you can see here, the record is inserted into server console. Sorry, database console, and same message displayed, record is inserted. But we need to clear these fields also. We have to clear these fields. So stop it here. And let me show you. Stop. Let me show you that console. Let me show you that operation. What is the operation that I've done here? Let me. I think I need to give the permissions here. Not this one. So USB charging, transfer files. So go to my device. So here is Redmi master recorder. So what is the operation I have done? Let me show you once again. Record master. So let me run this one. So it's almost 11 minutes, but anyhow we have to wait. We have to watch.
Here is my application launch. You can see here. The application is launched here. Okay. And then you can see in the camera. As well as let me start my Wi-Fi here. Wi-Fi. Let me go to Wi-Fi. Is it connected to the Wi-Fi or not? So here, yeah, it is connected to Redmi 4. It is connected to Redmi 4. Redmi 4. It is connected to Redmi 4. Done. So you can see here. Fine. So home is connected to my laptop. Sorry, my mobile device. Home is connected now. So where is my system? Laptop is getting hang. Sorry, not laptop, mobile. So why not make it off? Fine. So let me show you for next step. And here let me pause for time being. Where is that? So pause it, start the recording again in my device. So connected now. What is the IP address? Check it once again. My IP address here 192.168.23.1. So here student ID. Let me enter the student ID. So I'll enter all the details here. What are the enter? So enter the student ID, that is Ganesha. So sorry, student ID is. Suppose I took S1. Student ID is S1. Then you need to do parallel observe here. S1. Enter student name is Ganesha. 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 Enter age. Suppose I enter 20. Enter mobile number 98543. Some mobile number 985464. Email ID is Ganesha@gmail.com. gmail.com. Fine. Enter the password is Ganesha. So let me check it once again. Ganesha. Enter the server IP and port number in this way. So here is 192.168.23.1. So here 192.168.23.1:2020. Okay. So I have filled the form 192.168.23.1:2020. So this is the form you can see here. Okay, fine. So here I will enter all the details. Now let me hit the save the student. Now observe. You may get error or you may get the response. That's it. Fine. After this error, now let me check it now by entering the submit button. So hit the button now. Save student to server database. Either you should get error. So 75 web services example has stopped. Okay, let me check the crap. So yes, one. Okay, let me force in on my.
Okay guys, now you have seen the operation that I perform on my mobile as well as record is coming to my server window, server database. Now let us perform by using IP address. So here let's go to IP address. Where is the IP address now? So let me work with now IP address. So just remove this string field. Let me remove this string, final string, and let me have one more final string. Okay, let me make that final string is this one only. Okay, fine. So your URL, your string IP and context URL path. Okay, fine. So let me try. Last time I tried by using static. Okay, now this time I want to work with the different servers, different servers. So every time you need to get different servers, so currently my IP address is 123. So page down. Where is that page? Wi-Fi router, and this is my IP address 192.168.23. So command prompt IP config. Okay, so here is 192.168.23.1. Okay, fine. So let me rerun the application now. So this time I will test by using in this way. Okay, enter the IP address and port number of the server. So let me redeploy, reinstall the application. So run, hit OK. Now this time I have planned to install by using IP address. So still Gradle build. So wait until the Gradle has to build successfully. Once Gradle builds completes, then I will start now. Okay, fine. So 75 installing APK. So launching activity. So activity is launched now. Now this time I will enter by using IP address. So now student number is S2. So let me enter as a S2. Student name is Shankara. Shankara. Student age is suppose 23. Mobile number is some 123456. Email ID is shankar Shankara @gmail.com gmail.com shankara @gmail.com and password is Shankara only, shankara Shankara, and server IP address. So what is the server IP address? Just check it here. Go to notes. 192.168.23.1:2020. Okay, fine. So let me work with here also. Let me enable the keyboard here. That is number keyboard. By going to here, what is the hint type for what is let me enter the number. So here is number. Input type is number. Okay, for next time we will get the keyboard as a number. Okay, fine. But don't forget to add this request. I forget to initialize the request request queue. Okay, fine. So that's what I was getting the error. Now you can see, yes, save the student to the server. So let me keep my MySQL parallelly, as well as server console parallelly, and do observe. So you can see here I have entered the IP address. Okay, fine. So this is the IP address. You can check it here. Fine boss. So let me hit the save student to server database. Save student to server database. So I clicked. So I'm expecting here record inserted. You can see here Shankara two times inserted. Shankara two times. Okay, but just I forget to give the toast message here. We need to add this toast message also. Refresh. Shankara it's coming two times now. Okay guys, so let me delete one Shankara and close the fields. Delete. Yes. No. So let me make it S3 and save. I think it's reached to deadlock. Refresh. Three. Okay. Save. It reached to deadlock, guys. Deadlock. Fine. But anyhow, my record is inserted now. My record is inserted. Done by using both the ways. So let me stop it here. Let me show this recording also to you, as well as stop it. Stop and go to again server console, not server console, to my device. So here is record master. What is the operation I perform? Let me show you. So record master. So it's 3:13.
75 installing APK. So launching activity. So activity is launched now. So this time I will enter by using IP address. So now student number is S2. So let me enter as a S2. Student name is Shankara. Shankara. Student age is suppose 23. Mobile number is some 123456. Email ID is shankara Shankara @gmail.com Shankara @gmail.com and password is Shankara only, shankara Shankara, and server IP address. So what is server IP address? Just check it here. Go to notes. 3:1:2020. Okay, fine. So let also. Let me enable the keyboard here. That is number keyboard. By going to here. What is the hint type for? What is? Let me enter the number. So here is number. Input type is number. Okay. So next time you will get the keyboard as a number. Okay, fine. But don't forget to add this request. I forget to initialize the request request queue. Okay, fine. So that's why I was getting the error now. Now you can see here, save the student to the server. So let me keep my MySQL parallelly as well as server console parallelly and do observe. So you can see here I have entered the IP address. Okay, fine. So this is the IP address. You can check it here. Fine. So let me hit the save student to server database. Save student to server database. So I clicked up. So I'm expecting here record inserted. You can see here Shankara two times inserted. Shankara two times. Okay, like we need to add this toast message also. Shankara is coming two times now. No. Save. I think it's reached the deadlock. Refresh. Done.
Okay, guys, you have seen this recorded operations in the device. Now, let me perform some validation logic. Let me apply your validation logic and go scroll down. Go to button click event. Where is my button click event? So here is a button click. So before going to perform, so here let me check it here before. This is for new event handler. Okay, here let me check it. If not text utils dot equals to whom you are trying to test, SID one. Otherwise you can get it all the fields also. Otherwise you can check manually. SID1 dot equals of empty. Okay, that is student ID1 dot equals of empty. Okay, that is not equals, must be not equal. So or you have to check it for all equals, not equals. Okay, fine. Control C, then yes name dot yes name one equals of space, then age one dot equals of empty, then mobile one dot equals of empty. Fine. Next email dot equals of empty, then password and IP, then pass one dot equals of empty, then IP one dot equals of empty. Okay, was fine. So to show you whole string, we scroll left. Okay, fine. So if it is empty, then we'll show toast message. Please enter. Okay, all fields are compulsory. Toast dot make text. So here is my register activity dot this comma, all fields are mandatory or compulsory. Okay, fine. So let me show the message dot length is long dot show. Okay, else. Okay, boss. So let me keep this else block here in the event handler. So in the else block, so here is my event handler. So this is the for else block. So end of else. Okay, fine. So once you inserted, once record gets inserted, then we have to clear those fields. So SID dot set text dot that is empty. We set the text to all empty. So sname one not sname dot. So here simply paste sname. Okay, fine. Then what is next? H dot set text that is empty. Next after H, email ID email dot set text that is empty. Then 1 2 3 4 5. What is left now? Just check it. SID, yes name, then age, then mobile is left now. So mobile dot set text empty. Then pass one dot set text, not pass one, only pass dot set text. This is also empty. So IP don't set IP because every time we have to enter. Set text empty. So this time I'm skipping this IP. Okay, fine. So let me make it uncommented because one time only more than enough, because every time we have to enter and this may create that hectic to enter all the fields. So let me test the application once again. So deploy the application. Not deploy, install the APK. Then go to, so I have to start Gradle build running. So this is my last run. Once this last run gets complete, then hot swapping, hot swapped, start. Let me close this all app. Okay, this is my 75 web services. Why stopped? View error, view summary. Okay, illegal, no such field. Which, what is that? M assets. M assets in class Android, MIUI. Framework, it's a mobile issue, boss. So handler, activity handler. Handler, so I got illegal state exceptions. So, let me run once again. Need not to do hot swap, guys. Cancel. Gradle build running. So go to activity, launching activity. Again issue, cancel. So where is that issue? Let me clear and build. So this is anyhow record is inserted. No matter, but just I want to show you validation. Just I would have to show you validation. Okay, fine. So clean and rebuild the project. Gradle build running. We have to wait until the Gradle has to build. Once Gradle build finished, then we'll build and we'll test by using null null. Okay, what is it? Validation logic. Just I applied here register activity, then clearing the fields and clearing the fields. That's it. If Gradle build takes too much times, then I'll stop and I'll continue in next session. But before until it finishes the cleans, then in the next step now. We shall learn new part to check login. Okay, using web services. Using web services, that is part 2. Okay, fine. So here is my login activity. If login successful, then we'll proceed for home activity. If login is successful, then we'll proceed for we proceed to welcome activity. Okay. Gather build finish. Anyhow, record is successful. Anyhow, up to here. Up to here. Record is successfully inserted. Inserted to server database. To server database, that is MySQL. Now just try the experiment and let me know the feedback if any issues, any errors. And next tutorial we shall learn the new part for check the login using web services. Okay, I will add one more activity, login activity, and there we'll check the login successful or not. Okay, fine. Is Gradle build finished? So it is taking time, guys. I'll show this clearing the fields and testing this application in the next activity, in the next tutorial. Fine, thank you.